Hello viewers, welcome to our Facebook live session. Today we have with us our specialist Dr. Jaswinder Singh, ENT consultant at Apollo Hospital, Jubilee Hills, Hyderabad. Welcome to our session, sir.
Thank you.
Today in this live session, we will be discussing about strep throat. Before starting the session, kindly leave your question in the comment section. We will answer them during live. Sir, let us start the questions. Can you please explain us about the strep throat?
Yeah, thank you, Pavani, and hello everyone. Welcome you all for this today's program on Apollo Live-In. Strep throat or streptococcal sore throat is as the name suggests, is caused by bacteria called Streptococcus, and the infection usually affects the children between 5 and 15 years. Usually the pain is moderately severe to very severe. It has gained importance because it is one of the reasons for causing rheumatic fever. Usually causes swollen joints and painful joints and valvular heart disease. Also it can cause infection of the kidney, which is called as post-streptococcal pulmonary arthritis. But fortunately, streptococcal sore throat is in a minority. It doesn't affect many people.
Sir, what is sore throat and what is the difference between them?
Generally, sore throat is caused by viruses, rhinovirus, influenza, parainfluenza, and other viruses. Usually, it is milder in form, as patient will experience malaise, mild throat discomfort, and very mild pain. It can be associated sometimes with upper respiratory tract infection, usually sinusitis. Sometimes it can happen in people who have tonsil infection or poor oral hygiene. It can also affect people who have poor dental sepsis or dental sepsis. Sometimes people who take alcohol, tobacco chewing, smokers can have sore throat, and even spice. People who take a lot of spicy food and acid reflux can give rise to sore throat. Sometimes even environmental conditions such as staying in a dusty atmosphere and smoky atmosphere can give rise to.
What are the treatment options, sir?
Before going to treatment, I would like to tell you about the symptomatology. The patient, usually a strep throat or streptococcal sore throat patient, present with, as I told, between 5 and 15 years, but adults also do get it. So patient will come with very severe, moderately severe to severe pain in the throat, with high grade fever, malaise, body pains, headache. They'll have swollen glands in the neck, and as I said, high fever. And when they come to the clinician examines them, and we can find that they are enlarged lymph nodes which are in the neck. The throat is badly congested, and sometimes the clinician can find a lot of yellow patches over the tonsil and the pharyngeal walls. Usually it is a clinical diagnosis and by examination. And further down, you basically to diagnose 100%, you have to take a throat swab, which can help us in taking the culture, growing the bacteria in the culture. But that takes usually 2 days for us to get the report. And also, we can know the sensitivity of the organism to the antibiotic to be used. Now coming to the treatment as such, usually it is medical management. Patients, the first thing is general management, wherein they can have bed rest and good ventilation should be maintained in the room. They need hydration. A lot of people stop eating because of the pain, and such patients in fact require admission, and they will require IV fluids also. Analgesics are given either orally or through IV injectables. Antibiotics are started as soon as the condition is diagnosed, without waiting for the culture report. The preferable antibiotic is penicillin group of drugs, preferably amoxicillin, which is given orally. Or as I said, if the patient is not able to swallow, then we have, and the severity of the infection, patient needs to be given intravenous injections. We give amoxicillin clavulanic acid combination. Alternatively, some patients have allergic to penicillin, they need macrolides group of drugs, azithromycin or clarithromycin. And some patients we have to consider cephalosporins as well.
So in this rainy season and upcoming winter season, what is your advice how to go about it?
Basically, people have to maintain immunity. Immunity comes with good lifestyle, good habits, eating healthy food, doing regular exercise, and moreover, keeping your mental mind stable. And you should avoid taking certain things which you think that it can irritate your throat. Like as I said, smokers should be careful, tobacco chewing and spicy food needs to be avoided.
So during this COVID season, many people are drinking warm water. How advisable it is?
Warm water as such doesn't, there is no proof that it helps, but yes, it can give you some sort of soothing effect when you are taking, it gives you, when you are symptomatic, so it helps you in that. But scientifically, yes, there is no proof as such that it helps.
Okay, sir. In general, ENT, treatment approach, what is the treatment approach at Apollo and COVID precautions taken?
Treatment approach, before I start, I want to just highlight that Apollo is doing very good work and in taking care of the patients, all patients. When the patient walks in to the hospital, they are greeted by the front office staff, wherein there is no contact between them. Usually there is no thermal checking with a handheld device. Now it is through laser sensitive cameras which can record your temperature. Patient can just walking through, they just have to fill a COVID declaration form mentioning their details, and they are if at all they have fever, they are directed to the fever clinic where the further investigations are done. And if everything is okay, they are allowed to meet their consultant of choice. As far as emergencies are concerned, we have a robust plan. Emergency patients are first taken care of by the they go to the triage area, which is usually by taken care by the experts, the ID specialist. And we have a separate our emergency separate for COVID and non-COVID patients. And all the patients are they undergo two net tests to rule out the COVID possibility. And once the patient is selected for surgery, we do, other than the routine test, we are advising them RT-PCR of the nasal and oropharyngeal swabs to just make sure that for their safety and for the safety of the medical people who are attending on them. And some people also, we are recommending HRCT of the chest, because COVID can affect the chest and show early signs can be detected in the, even though patient is asymptomatic, can be, it's very sensitive to find out if the patient is having COVID possibility.
One of the viewers had asked you a question, sir. Do we get upper respiratory infection for the medication Moytoy LC and Metatop spray that we use for allergic rhinitis?
These are the treatment for allergic rhinitis, allergy symptoms. Metatop and the other levocetirizine with montelukast combinations are basically used to take care of allergy. It is given in allergies because allergies are more prone for upper respiratory or lower respiratory tract infections. So, and since allergy has to be controlled before they get catch any infections, so ideally they are put on these drugs to maintain that they don't get the symptoms of allergy and hence upper respiratory tract infections.
Sir, one last question. Can you briefly tell us about the cochlear implant program?
Yeah, certainly. Before telling about our program, I just want to tell our viewers that what is cochlear implant? Cochlear implant is a electronic device, an implantable hearing device, which stimulates the nerve endings in the cochlea. It is used in people, especially in children who have severe to profound hearing loss in both the ears, or they are born deaf. Such kids don't benefit with regular hearing aids or conventional hearing aids, so they need the cochlear implant device. And when we started cochlear implant, it was in 1994. It was started in Apollo under the leadership of Dr. E. C. Vinay Kumar. And in fact, last year we have completed 25 years of the Apollo cochlear implant program at Apollo Hospital. So far we have done around 1600 cases, and I feel pride in telling that it is one of the highest numbers in the country for any given center. And per year we have been doing around 120 cases, and we have served patients not only from the state of Telangana and Andhra Pradesh, but and the country as a whole, but we have patients from all over the globe. And we want to continue serving the patients.
Thank you so much, sir. I'll just check with more questions. Sir, please tell us about the seasonal infection in children causing cough and cold.
Again, I said it is mainly viral. Viral, as I said in the beginning, sore throat. Usually it is viral, and children do get affected because they have low immunity. So first 5 years of age, they keep getting this upper respiratory infections. Yes, they have to be, parents have to be very careful when their child suffers the upper respiratory tract infection. The proper antibiotics have to be chosen, and since the airway is very small in children, they can have problems in breathing. So yes, they should be attended at the emergency basis.
So when is the right time to come and see an ENT specialist, especially in children?
As soon as they get symptoms, especially cough, which is not coming down, say within 2-3 days, if they are given any home remedy or anything, if it is not coming down, it is better not to delay more than 72 hours.
Okay, sir. And how about the adults, sir? Adults, what precautions they should take?
Adults, they should initially start with sore throat, and then they start having cough and running nose and all those issues. Initially, they can try with some warm saline goggles, and over the counter, they can usually, it's available, they can take some tablets. As I said, not more than 72 hours. They have to seek medical help if it is going beyond 72 hours.
Any first aid that can be taken at home?
They can, as I said, one thing is saline goggles. They can take steam. They can take lemon and honey. These are the home remedies. I think helps them keeping in good shape initially.
Sir, before closing, any last advice you want to give it to the viewers?
Last advice is my advice is that stay healthy, stay safe. COVID period, it is a trying time for all of us. Wear your mask and maintain your